Number four is internal audit presentation by Tobin and company. Are they present?
Aren't we finishing the students' comments?
Sir? Yeah, coming forward here.
Okay. Dr. Ostetcher, can you introduce the Tobin?
What's happening?
Daniel will.
That's before. So we're up to. You got to follow the agenda. Yeah, but if you look at the agenda, that's number four, and then down to number six. Following the agenda.
Okay.
We got to follow the agenda.
Just let them know what you're doing.
So we skipped over the students.
Well, if you follow the agenda, we set an agenda and we posted it. And the way it works is you follow the agenda as it's been posted. And I just noted the number four on the agenda is meeting of the audit committee, and then we'll move on to reports and communications students, which is number six, and we'll continue with students.
As an infant who has a mother who's a victim of the earthquake in Haiti, may I please have the right to call for at least 3 minutes?
What was that?
As an infant who has a mother who is a victim of the earthquake in Haiti, may I please talk for 3 minutes, please?
Yes, you can.
Thank you.
Well, the agenda is there,
you know,
but
we'll
make
it. The agenda was a little bit different this time, and we had the audit committee report first and then the public speaking after that. But somehow we got started with the public speaking instead of the audit report. So we want to go back to the agenda and do the audit report and then get back to the students' public speaking.
In all respect, but wouldn't it be easier to just finish the same program that we participated first and then continue to the consequent one?
Well, yeah, you did. I ruled that you could speak, notwithstanding what Ms. Coleman has said, you can speak for 3 minutes and address the board, and right afterwards we'll have the auditor company present their presentation.
Thank you, Mr. This is a speech that I wrote. My name is Stephane Fouche, by the way. The words that sit on the lips of everyone are budget cuts after cuts after cuts. With the state of the economy, it seems that these words slide over mouths more often than they ought to. In our schools, we have felt the pain of these so-called cuts, but quieted ourselves at their frontal attacks. When some of our favorite teachers bid our students farewell because they lost their jobs, we managed a way to not cry. When sports spendings were cut, we were disenchanted but managed with the little that we had. When spending was cut for some after-school activities, we groaned at the fact that we were slowly losing everything, but still, this fire in us managed to stay lit. Now there are news of AP classes probably being cut. But no more shall we students stay on the sidelines and watch our education simply being out of the way. I myself have taken 10 of the 13 AP classes offered in my school, and I've passed every single one of them. The only reason why this number is not any higher was because I did not take any my freshman year. Although my junior year, I did challenge the AP French by myself with the help of my teacher and receive a 5. This was then, but now is now. The upcoming freshmen are entering AP Biology in 9th grade under the wing of Ms. LaValle. May I recall that the top 5% of every graduating student body at Spring Valley High School has received a good score on that test, and I myself, a 5, in my second year in moving to the United States. I was an ESL student. You might not believe it, or you might not, but English was never my forte. But under the care of Ms. Bond and Mr. Russo, I was able to get a 3 on my AP English exam. That is a success for a previous ESL student.
Sure is.
For Mr. Ferraro's boot camp, that's how we nicknamed it out of school, my sophomore year, I learned about the different cultures of this world and how to write a cohesive essay under time constraint. May I also mention that I was the only boy in my school to receive a 4 in that exam, the AP World exam. Finally, another highlight I must give to you is that we are in a conflict with the College Board. They specifically stated that chemistry must be taken through 2 years, but Ms. Hillsman did it in 1 year with 100% passing rate. I personally scored a 5 on her test and 770 over 800 on the chemistry, which is the hardest AP exam ever given. Our schools are capable of producing brilliant scholars through the use of a rigorous curriculum that puts us in competition with the rest of the nation, not just this county. Simply cutting these classes will strip us of the edge that we held for so long. Thus, I am against the cutting of these classes, but on the other hand, I am for the implementation of new ones. Certain school districts have about 21 AP classes. The maximum we had about was 15. If the priority of the school board, therefore, is to forward our education, I dread to ask, why take the classes that are the most valuable to our school? Better yet, if the AP classes have proven such a high level of success among our schools, what is the logic behind cutting them? A little analogy I have is that if a farmer would not cut the tree that bears him the most fruit, therefore I would think that the Board of Education would shield the program that provides such success to the schools that are under their care. Our school now has 13 of these AP classes. Implementing them took time, work, and sweat from dedicated teachers. They have put into perfecting their craft into teaching these classes. Taking them away from these dedicated teachers would be a frontal assault to them, and finally to the students. The indirect message that we'll receive would be, I don't care about you, or I don't give about your education, or you are not worth the money that is being spent. Ultimately, I would like to leave you with this in mind. I am a senior at my school. Therefore, why should I care about AP classes if I'm leaving next year? The answer is simple, very simple. I care about my school, and it rips me apart to see that cuts in the budget are causing education to slowly bleed out of our schools. I am asking, and I am pleading. I am not arguing, just pleading and begging. Please mend these wounds. Do not deepen them. Thank you.